I have made a series of color studies in painting simply flowers, seeking oppositions of blue and orange, red and green, yellow and violet, seeking the broken and neutral tones to harmonize brutal extremes, trying to render intense color and not gray harmony. Simply flowers, said Van Gogh. Simply colors. Color is the absolute central motive of one of his last and for me most extraordinary and modern series made by Van Gogh. In Paris, 1887, late summer, Van Gogh painted four still life of sunflowers. These four sunflowers, we can see a Van Gogh that foreshadows the last Van Gogh, a groundbreaking, expressive, tremendous Van Gogh. The most fresh and impressive of the four paintings made in Paris is that preserved in the Metropolitan Museum in New York. It's not wired because this version, along with the one kept at Kunstmuseum Bern, were owned by his friend Gauguin, and they held pride of place above the bed in his Paris apartment. In the mid-1890s, when he sold his most prized possessions to finance his suitor's voyage, were both sold to Ambroise Vollard. Gauguin himself dedicated a painting to Van Gogh, where he appears painting the sunflowers. In those years, we have also the amazing portrait of Van Gogh made by Toulouse-Lautrec. Van Gogh drawing in a cafe in Paris. The best known Van Gogh sunflowers are those of the Neue Pinakothek in Munich or those of the National Gallery in London. Sunflowers painted a year later. Sunflowers in glass, like a traditional still life, but the ones kept in Bern or at the Metropolitan New York are cut sunflowers without a glass, but are extremely more modern and incisive in the brushwork. As Van Gogh himself said, they are just sunflowers. Because the important thing is the color and the light. This is the meaning of the series. To find and to study the chromatic and light evolution. For this reason, in 1887, he painted three of these sunflowers and one sketch. Brutal extremes, said Van Gogh. Brutal extremes, brutal blue, like the blue of his Orsay self-portrait of the Starry Night, blues that evolve and change in infinite varieties at the stroke of a brush like a shining knife. Contrapositions. Contrapositions of color and composition. Contrapositions between what is painted and the empty of textured canvas. Two opposed sunflowers in their natural strength, fresh from the field. Taking a new life with the oil that even today, brutality breeds in the line. Van Gogh here is stark, is sublime, is the best Van Gogh.
A Van Gogh that flees from the traditional form of still life and enters to the contemporary world. A Van Gogh increases. The Van Gogh who wants to flee from Paris and seek nature in his final years. Van Gogh seeking nature. The chromatic strength and three-dimensionality of this Van Gogh are extraordinary. And this explains why Gauguin has had them as his head book.